enterprise resource product, we were using SAP 4.7, which has been fully made up operational. And now from SAP 4.7, we have already migrated to six SAP Enterprise Central Component version 6. In the under this, we have plant maintenance, project systems, and HRMS, payroll data monitoring. Particularly, I would just briefly mention each of that. Project management system is specifically designed to provide comprehensive and fully integrated project management function. Projects are defined, structured into organizational form that map to the specific project. Project is broken down to levels of activities like internal activities, external activities, cost activities, and material component. Entire workflow of all these bulk projects, schemes, improvements, and deposit contribution works is captured in the PS module. Different stages of execution of scheme project can be monitored. Transparency is being brought in as the entire execution of the scheme is made available and is monitored at any level, and from anywhere it can be monitored. Plant maintenance, particularly an organization dealing with large quantities of, huge quantities of equipment, we need to keep a clear track of each and every one of our major equipments, particularly like the distribution transformers, the power transformers, and some of the major components. The distribution transformers, for example, they number about 250,000 distribution transformers in this entire company area. So each and every distribution transformer location is available, each and every distribution transformer's history, in the sense when it was installed and when it has gone for a first repair, the second repair, the third repair, and so on till it's in condemned shape and it comes back for as a scrap. Similarly is the meters, the regular energy meter, which also number about 70 lakhs, because I'm saying 70 lakhs because of the 80 lakh consumers, 10 lakh agriculture consumers are not fully covered for the metering. Only the income tax payees are covered for metering in agriculture sector. So we do have a track of this 60 lakh energy, 70 lakh energy meters as it is used from it, the from the time it is used, installed, brought back, whenever it's there is a problem in the meter and it is condemned and it's discarded, till that time this number and the location is monitored. So this gives a clear track of various kinds of repairs which are taken up on different various kinds of equipment. Similar is the case of other distribution transformers. I would briefly touch upon this RAPDRP. RAPDRP stands for Reformed Accelerated Power Distribution and Reforms Project. So this is with the assistance of Ministry of Power, Government of India. So the central sector scheme started in July 2008. The main focus of this program is to establish reliable and automated systems for collection of baseline data, adoption of IT in areas of energy auditing and accounting, consumer establishment of consumer care centers, strengthening of distribution network of state power utilities, primarily to reduce the AT&C losses. AT&C losses stand for technical and commercial, aggregate technical and commercial losses. It also envisages establishment of SCADA, which is Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition System, and also Distribution Management System in major towns, and capacity building, incentive scheme for distribution personnel, etc. Power Finance Corporation has been coordinating, and it's the nodal agency in this operation of this. So basically, this contains two parts. Part A includes the projects for establishment of baseline data and IT applications for energy accounting and auditing and IT-based consumer service centers. Part B shall include regular distribution strengthening projects, which is more of a hardware part of it. What is related to the IT initiatives all falls in part A, so which includes consumer indexing, asset mapping, GIS mapping of the entire distribution network, automatic meter reading on distribution transformers and feeders, automatic data logging for all distribution transformers and feeders, SCADA DMS in major towns and cities with population over 4 lakhs and energy input of more than 350 million units, feeder segregations, ring fencing, establishment of IT-enabled customer care service centers, establishment of baseline data system. I would leave this apart, this part, because this is more of a hardware part of it. Okay, this is also fine. This is the broad breakup of, right now under Part A, IT initiatives, 30 towns which are above 30,000 population have been taken up. And the IT initiatives include each and every distribution transformer in those towns is metered, and the energy input in that town through the available substation is measured, and that has to again finally aggregate the distribution transformers, whatever they record, the aggregate should come properly, and we can monitor this online, continuously monitor the distribution transformer, what is happening at the distribution transformer level. That is, the various phases are available, active, the energy input, is there a loss, various aspects can be monitored continuously. And under this project, they included all these parameters or these various kinds of applications and softwares which are to be developed. Fortunately, we already had Central Power Distribution Company had already most of these applications which were already developed in-house. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition System. Basically, in major cities and towns, to continuously online monitor the status of the substations, all the substations which are located in a major city, like let's say Hyderabad, we have over 280 substations within the city, which finally deliver energy or power to the consumer. So the status of each and every such substation is very, very important. So online at one place, it can be monitored, the status of each substation, the various equipment components in each of that substation can be monitored. Any faults can be isolated so that it does not reflect in larger areas of outage, and it can be restricted to a very small area, and immediate corrective actions, corrective steps can be taken. This is the architecture. This is what I was telling about the outage management system. Particularly, in the traditional way, the people will have to travel along the power lines, will have to identify the problem, identify the fault or disturbance, and then take up corrective actions. So through this outage management system, we are planning to install fault location indicators, and through this fault location indicators, it can be identified, located at a very short time, and then the corrective action can be taken. So the interruptions and disturbance to the consumer would be to the least. These list out the various benefits and the impact, which would also reflect in our revenues, because if I am not able to supply for a particular period of time, then the consumption is lost forever. So which even if I have subsequently, the time can't be recovered. These are the things which have already been done. The data center has been established. Centralized customer call centers have been done. Call center reports with section automation systems and online spot collections, auto generation of notices, software for theft cases, assessment amounts collections, KVEH billing, okay, I'll leave that. Integration of LT multi-services apartments with energy billing systems. Just one another aspect which unfortunately is not covered in my presentation, I would like to briefly touch upon. Now, the next stage after the automation at the DTR level, from the distribution transformer level, the information can be monitored through in the central server up to the distribution transformer level. Next, further what? Is it just sufficient to stop at the distribution transformer level? No. Probably we need to even go up to the consumer meter level and to understand what is happening at the consumer's location. So only then we'll be able to exactly pinpoint if there are losses taking place, where the losses are occurring, whether it is in particular consumer area or in a particular location as such. So the next step is the smart metering in energy sector, particularly smart meterings which have features for two-way communication with these meters. That is, we'll be able to receive data from the meters remotely without a person actually reaching there, and also be able to communicate to the meter. Like, for example, there is a theft or there is an excessive usage without the sanctioned kind of a load. So the meter can be remotely shut down from our central server location. Similarly, in terms of demand response system, what I mean is with the deficit in energy in most of the states and at particular periods of the time, that is particularly from evening 6:30 to 8:30 or 9:30, where the energy demand is at its peak, the system probably cannot take the entire load. So the present available tool is to totally shut down a particular area or more than one particular area to reduce the demand on the system, to keep the system safe and stable. With the IT application, probably it should be possible that instead of a total blackout in any particular area or any particular larger area, we can think of having a brownout, in the sense to reduce through our ICT to send a message to the consumers, and the utilities can send these messages to the consumers so that the consumer reduces his usage and everybody is able to have at least the lighting load without having to have a total blackout. So work is being done on this aspect on the smart metering system. So we are yet to establish the standards and proceed in these lines. So these are some of the initiatives and what are the possibilities that are there. I have just briefly touched upon. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.